Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is your Kamal sir, lecturer department of mathematics, scholars school and college, Dhanmondi, Dhaka. My dear students, most welcome to all of you. Inshallah, today we are going to discuss TET question from statistical data and information, which is chapter 8. Already in our last classes, we have done two creative questions. Inshallah, today we will do two more creative questions. So, first, let me know top line of the board, right side, left side, and lighting, sound quality, is everything okay? Can we start our class formally? My dear students, in the comment section, you can give your attendance and you can tag your friends to connect with us. Inshallah, within a short time, we are going to start our class formally. This is question number 3. The secured marks in students. Find the median and mode of the data. How many students can do this answer properly? Please, in the comment section, you can give your write your name. It's too much easy question. Already we have done these types of question. So, first one, about the data and information, organized and unorganized. Arithmetic mean, how to find the median and mode. Okay, now, is this data an organized data? It not organized it. So definitely the organized order means the information will be in ascending order or descending order. I think all of you know what is ascending order and what is descending order. When you see given information or given data is from the smallest number to large number, this one is called ascending order. When you see the large number to smallest number gradually, then we call this data in descending order. If we see that given information in ascending order or descending order, it will be in organized. But here, 92, 95 increasing, then again 70, 79 decreasing, then decreasing, decreasing, then again increasing. So there is no data here or arranged in ascending or descending order. Definitely, is this data an organized order? No, definitely not. This is not in organized order. So, first question answer, we can write solution 1. Given data is not in given data is not organized. So given data is not organized. Now data in ascending order. Data in ascending order. So ascending order indicates you smallest number to large number, gradually increasing order. First you have to find out the smallest number, then find out the large number. So smallest to gradually large number. This is called the ascending order. So now just too much easy, find out the smallest number. Which one is smallest number? The 38, I think. 38 here. 95, 50, 50, 38. Yes. The smallest number is 38. Then 30. There is no more 30. 38. And then now, find out the 40 scale. 48, 48. 97, 99 and 100. 99 and 100, if you want, okay? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So 15 information data in ascending order. So organized order indicate to you the organized. It may be in ascending order or descending order. So in ascending order, our answer, if you organize the data, this one. Now, determine the arithmetic mean of the data. Number B answer, arithmetic mean. So arithmetic mean, arithmetic mean will be sum of the data and number of data. এখানে আমাদের যতগুলো information আছে sum of the data divided by number of data. So dear students, try to answer this one. Yes, already ascending order, Sabir Hussain said yes. Sum of all data, I think if you do add all number, even you say the ascending order 38 plus 45 plus 48 plus 59 79 plus again 79 then plus 80 plus 92 plus 95 plus 79 97 plus 99 plus 100 divided by how many students? There are 15 students. So I think up to this one is okay to you. Now do add here. My dear students, doing the add, result will be 1097 and then divided by 15. So doing the simple calculation, you will get here result 73.13. This is your arithmetic mean of the data. My dear students, determine the arithmetic mean of the data, which is 73.13. Just you have to give attention in terms of doing add. Maximum time students do mistake or they just spend their time in doing the addition here. So just need to give more attention in terms of doing add. The answer is 79.13. Now find the median and mode. Now we will do second question. I think all of you know this one, how to find the arithmetic mean. Sum of the data divided by number of data. So my dear students, if you have any more questions, please let me know. Yes. 15 minutes plus 20 minutes A. Okay. My dear students, now this is okay to you, I think. Now we are going to discuss here next question, which is question number C. Question number C. Median. Median is the middle one. So, data in ascending order in the median. Data in ascending order. So in terms of median, and you have to arrange the data in ascending order. So we can write here 38 45 plus 48 48 plus 50 plus 68 plus 79 plus 79. I think no need to use here plus. All data will be separated by comma. because we are finding here not arithmetic mean, only median and mode, 79, and next one 79, and 80, 92, 95, 80, 92, 95, 97, 99, and 100. So now we can erase this one. Median here, number of data is 15, which is an odd number. Odd number, so median equal n plus 1 divided by 2 th from. So n means the number of data, you can write here number of data n equal 15, then you can apply here value of n. So now value of n is 15. 15 plus 1 divided by 2, this one is th. You can erase this one. Arithmetic mean, 15 plus 1, 16 divided by 2, th. So 8. The 8 term is the, in ascending order, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. 8th term is 79, which is our answer. So, my dear students, this is our median by using the formula n plus 1 divided by 2 term. N is the number of data. We applied here two formula. When the given data is in odd number, then we will apply this formula. And when the given data is even number, then we have to apply another formula. Already we have done in our previous classes. So n plus 1, 15 plus 1 divided by 2, 16 plus 1 divided by 2. And we see in the exam hall, sometimes the student, unfortunately, they write here answer 8. No, 8 is not answer. Indicate you here 8 term. So 8 term in ascending order, the 8th number in the serial number 8 is 79. If you find here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But in the given information, 8 term is 68. But in the median, you have to give attention, without ascending order, you cannot identify which one is exact 8 number serial. So ascending order, first you have to arrange the data in ascending order, then find the 8th term, which is 79, this one is your answer. Now, next word is the mode. Mode is too much easy question here. The 48 repeated 2 times, and 79 here repeated 3 times. Definitely 70 times will be mode. So now, we can write here mode. Here, 79 repeated 3 times. Here 79 repeated 3 times. Which is maximum? Which is maximum? So mode is 79. So in the same here, median is 79, also mode is 79. My dear students, in time of finding the mode, no need to arrange the data in ascending order or descending order, but in median, and you have to arrange the data in ascending order. Without ascending order, median answer will not be correct. So, in times of mode, no need. Just identify which one is the maximum time repeated. We see here, 38 appear one time, 40, 45 one time, 48 two times, 51 time, for 68 one time, 79 only three times, which is the maximum. So max the number which is repeated maximum times is called mode. So mode is 79 here. My dear students, I hope this is okay to you. If you have any more questions, please let me know. I will review your comments. Then I will try to answer as far as you demand. If you have no questions, you can write in the comment section you sort down. Dear students, try to comment here. Thank you, sir. How now we have to do ascending order or descending order or both? Yes, and Umme Salman said, organized order, in which one we have to do ascending order or descending order? My request, if the question you don't see here mentioning ascending order or descending order, just you can write ascending order. It's okay, no problem. তুমি যদি বোথ কেস লিখো যে অ্যাসেন্ডিং অর্ডার এবং ডিসেন্ডিং অর্ডার দুটোই হবে, আর শুধু অ্যাসেন্ডিং অর্ডার লিখলে হবে স্যার। যে স্টুডেন্টস তোমাদের আর কারো কোনো কোশ্চেন না থাকলে আমরা ইয়েস স্যার ক্লিয়ার টু ইউ ইফ এনিওয়ান টেক দিস স্ক্রিনশট প্লিজ আপলোড দ্য পিকচারস অফ দ্য গ্রুপ। হ্যাঁ, আই থিঙ্ক আজকে স্যার এক্সপ্লেন, নো নিড টু এক্সপ্লেন অ্যাগেন। ওকে স্যার, খুবই সিম্পল কোশ্চেন ছিল, এর থেকে খুব সহজ কোশ্চেন নর্মালি তোমরা এর আগে আর করো না, ইটস টু মাচ ইজি। ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্টস, আই থিঙ্ক I have reviewed more than 30 copy homework submitted you in the last classes. Maximum is sometimes I saw here few students have done mistake in the in drawing the figure of line diagram, and so let me explain the line diagram again. I think I will take 10 more minutes. Inshallah, within 10 minutes we will complete this one properly. And from the next class, we will discuss arithmetic part, which is chapter 1. So, dear students, so আমাদের যে লাস্ট যে হোমওয়ার্কটা আমাদের ছিল, আমি র্যান্ডমলি কিছু নাম্বার এখানে তোমাদেরকে ইউজ করে দেখাবো। দিস ওয়াজ রান, দিস ওভার, ফার্স্ট ওভার, ফার্স্ট, সেকেন্ড, থার্ড, ফোর্থ, ফিফথ, সিক্স, সেভেন অ্যান্ড এইট নাম্বার। ফার্স্ট ওভার রান ইজ লাইক 10, সেকেন্ড ওভার রান ইজ লাইক 15, থার্ড ওভার রান ইজ 9, ফোর্থ ওভার রান ইজ 6 অ্যান্ড ফিফথ ওভার রান ইজ 2, সিক্স ওভার রান ইজ 12, 7 of our supposed run is 5 and 8 of our run is 8 of our run is 3. So dear students, আমরা এখান থেকে একটা লাইন ডায়াগ্রাম কিভাবে ড্র করতে হয় আমরা এই জিনিসটা আজকে আবার একটু ডিসকাস করব। গত ক্লাসে আমি কিছু স্টুডেন্ট হোমওয়ার্কে দেখেছিলাম যে এখানে এক্স এক্সিস এর সাথে ওয়াই এক্সিস এ তোমাদের যে কানেকশন, এখানে অনেকের একটু ফিগারটা প্রবলেমে প্রবলেম ছিল। তো যদি আমরা এখানে একটু ডিসকাস করি, লেট মি রিভিউ হিয়ার, একটু দেখে নাও। দিস ওয়ান ইজ কল এক্স এক্সিস, ও এক্স ইন্ডিকেট ইউ হিয়ার এক্স এক্সিস অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ ওয়াই এক্সিস, y axis, x axis here we can write here over, over, in y axis we can mention here run. So total we see here 8 over, first over, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. and maximum run is 12. Fifth, sorry, maximum run is 15. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, you can mention here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So first over run, the first over along the x-axis, along y-axis, the first over run up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. The first over run is 10. So along the x-axis we turn up to 10. So just give attention here, this is just above the first over and in the line direction up to 10. Give here, this is the line direction up to 10. So first, if we consider here like this, if we consider here like this, first over and here up to 10. So this is basically the first over run up to 10. Then similarly, a second over run up to 15. So second over run, this one will be up to 15. Like this one up to 15. Then third over run up to 9. Third over run up to 9. So this one will be up to 9. Just below 10. Then fourth over run up to 6. Fourth over run up to 6. This one will be up to 6. Fourth over run up to 6. Then fifth over run up to 2. Fifth over run only 2, up to 2. So this one is the up to 2 unit, the first unit, second unit. Then sixth over run up to 12. The sixth over run up to 12. So this one like this up to 12. Just give attention here, up to 12. Up to 12, this one will be here. Up to 12 and here 6 over. In a straight line, it will be a rectangular shape with the along x-axis and y-axis. Then 7th over run is 5. So 7th over run is 5. So this one is the up to 5. 7th over run is up to 5. Then 8th over run is up to 3. 8th over run is up to 3. So this does indicate you the separate point, and if you draw first over run with second over run is the single line here, one line. So no need to show this one. Another line, third over run to fourth over run, fourth over run to fifth over run, fifth over run to sixth over run, then 6 over run to 7 over run, 7 to 8. So this is looks like a line, first line, second line. So see here, this is a straight line, this is the line, third line. So this is not a straight line, but line. That's why this one is called line diagram. Line, this is called the line diagram. So, just I see sometimes, just you give here 8 over here, but you mention here the run is here. So, how? This is not according to x-axis and y-axis. And your point will be placed according to x-axis and y-axis. X-axis indicate you here 5, and up to this one indicate you here the run. So, this point along with the x-axis and y-axis, we have drawn here the line diagram, which is shown in the figure. And how to explain the figure? In the x-axis, mutually to perpendicular line indicate here x-axis and y-axis. Or you can start here, OX is x-axis, OY equal y-axis. The placing x-axis in the over and y-axis round. Now putting all values and where the over in x-axis, long x-axis runs in y-axis, we get here the line diagram, which is shown in the figure. So my dear students, I think, thank you very much. If you have any questions, please let me know. I will review your comment section. And if you have no questions, then inshallah we will leave our class today. And so, let me know.
Line diagram, yes. Everything okay, Ferdows Akhtar said. Thank you, sir. Shurma Shibriha. Yes, sir, thank you. Sir, homework.
I think you are homework. Tomader kache ki dewa jay kina. Okay, dear students, asha kori tomader aske ekhane tomader ar jodi karo kono question na thake. ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ আর আজকে তোমাদেরকে কোনো হোমওয়ার্ক দিচ্ছি না আজকে দিনটা জাস্ট এনজয় এন্ড এনজয় বাট নো রিস্ক আজকে তোমাদের ফ্রি ইনশাআল্লাহ আমরা আগামী ক্লাস থেকে আবার শুরু করব তোমাদের কাজ হচ্ছে আজকে স্ট্যাটিস্টিক্যাল ডাটা ইনফরমেশন একেবারে ভালো করে রিভাইজ দেওয়া যাতে যে কোনোভাবে কোশ্চেন আসলে তোমরা পরীক্ষায় আনসার করতে পারো সো ওকে মাই ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্টস ইনশাআল্লাহ টুমোরো উই উইল ডিসকাস অ্যারিথমেটিক পার্ট হুইচ ইজ এক্সারসাইজ 1.6 If we complete 1.6, our math syllabus and total maths book will complete, inshallah. So, wish you all the best and hope see you again in the next classes at 4 p.m. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Don't forget to subscribe. Triangular Kamal.